The example I'm going to use consists of a class called ImageReaderFactory, which provides a factory method, which is this one, createImageReader. As you can see, the method takes an input stream as input and returns an object of type ImageReader. And it's static, so that we can invoke it even if we don't have an instance of the ImageReaderFactory. So what does the method do? Well, the method first invokes getImageType, passing the input stream as a parameter, and this method figures out the type of the image that is stored in this input stream, and it's an integer. Then, based on the value of this integer, the method does one of several things. If the image type is a GIF, it will invoke the constructor for GIF reader, passing the stream as a parameter. And what will happen is that the GIF reader will read a GIF from the stream, create the corresponding object, and return it. So in this case, the image reader object return will be the object representing a GIF as appropriate. Similarly, if the image type is JPEG, then the method will invoke the constructor for JPEG reader. And in this case, this constructor will read from the stream a JPEG, create a corresponding object, and return it, and so on for different types of images. So why is this a situation in which it is appropriate to use the factory method pattern? Well, because it corresponds exactly to the cases that we saw before of applicability. This is a case in which we don't know the type of the object that we need to create until we run the code, because it depends on the value of the input stream. It depends on the content of the input stream. So until we read the input stream, we cannot figure out whether we need to create a GIF, a JPEG, or some other type of image. So in this case, what we want to simply delegate to these classes the creation of the object once we know what type of object needs to be created. So perfect example of application of a factory method pattern.